Bible lesson for this morning is in the book of Galatians, chapter 5, verse 22 and 23. They were getting to the 23 verse. Let's read the whole thing. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. And this is the word of the Lord. Let us pray. Father, help us to receive your word. Help us to learn from you. Bless us, O Lord. Talk to us. Pray that your Spirit will open our hearts and minds. And help us to understand what you have to say. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. I have someone, today we're talking about gentleness, but I have someone that insisted to come today, and he almost didn't come, but he said, I'll be there, and I said, okay, we'll wait for you. So he is right here with us, so hold on.
There is power inside. There is
wildness inside, but it is under control. That is the word gentleness. And we saw this in the Beatitudes when Jesus said, blessed are the meek. He used it, it's the same word here. So let's take a look, because we need to understand that those characteristics are part of the fruit that the Spirit put inside of us, and the Spirit put Jesus Christ inside of us. He's the seed of Christ, and that seed has gentleness. But it is the character of Christ. So let's take a look, because it's very important for us that all those characteristics are characteristics from Christ Himself. Look what 2 Corinthians 10:1 tells us. By the meekness and gentleness of Christ, I appeal to you. So Jesus has meekness and gentleness. And Jesus said in Matthew 11:29, He said, take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. Jesus is saying that He is gentle. And then we have, when Jesus is entering Jerusalem, Matthew 21 says this, verse 5, say to the daughter of Zion, see, your king comes to you, gentle and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey. So the Son of God, the third person of the Trinity, the most powerful being in the universe, is gentle, meek, humble. And it's very important for us to understand that. And how should we manifest that? Let me share with you some areas where we should find gentleness in our lives. So the first aspect, or the first way to manifest that, is the adornment of Christian wives. Look what 1 Peter 3:3-4 says. Your beauty, he's talking to the women, your beauty should not come from outward adornment, such as braided hair, wearing of gold jewelry, and fine clothes. Instead, it should be that of your inner self, the unfading beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is of great worth in God's eyes. How many fights in the home if the husband and the wife, the parents and the kids were gentle to each other? Gentle to each other. How many fights, struggles would be avoided? So it should manifest in the family. Second, should manifest during discipline. Paul is saying here, Galatians 6:1 says, brothers, if someone is caught in sin, you who are spiritual should restore him gently. Restore him gently. Someone messed it up. How are we going to deal with that? Oh, if we mess it up, this is the way that we treat people that mess it up, the sinners and all that kind of thing. No. Be gentle. The idea of discipline is to restore. It's not to banish the person. It's to create a way to bring the person back to the path. So we have to do this with our kids. We have to do this in the church. During discipline, be gentle. The next way of sharing, share the good news. How we share the good news? Peter says that we should use a manifest gentleness there. 1 Peter 3:15 says, but in your heart, set apart Christ as Lord. Always be prepared to give an answer to everyone who asks you to give the reason for the hope that you have. It's a preach the gospel. How am I going to preach the gospel? How am I going to give the reason, the hope that I have? I should be prepared to answer the questions that they have. How do I do that? I do this with gentleness and respect. And I believe that a lot of preachers here would kind of, I think that they missed that verse in the seminary. Because people say, hey, you're going to go. gentleness and respect them. Can you tell me a story for me? Can you talk about God without yelling and screaming and condemning me? Can you do that? Sharing the good news with gentleness. And finally, Paul covers the whole thing, said, feel everybody and treat everybody with gentleness. Titus 3:2 says, learn to know one, to be peaceful and considerate, and to show true humility. The word humility here is the same word in Greek. They just translated in English for another word. But it's the same word in Greek, gentleness. Show true gentleness toward everybody. How do I treat people with gentleness? With gentleness. It's power under control. This is it. This is gentleness. It's power under control. Do you have the power to do something? To be mean? To be violent? Do you have that power inside? You're boiling? Do you have the power to explode? Yes, but I'm going to control that. And I'm going to talk gently. Inside, I'm boiling. Outside, I look good. I'm nice. I have good words. It's control. Hang in there. Sometimes we can do it, sometimes we cannot. So we should develop. We're not born with those things, you know. That control, we didn't have it. And some of us are still struggling to have that. So how can I develop that? Let's take a look. The first thing that the Bible says that we should do is to develop by the Word of God. Gentleness comes with the Word, with the Spirit. This is why James 1:21 says, therefore get rid of all moral filth and the evil that is prevalent, and humbly, the same word, gently accept the word planted in you, which can save you. Gently receive the word. Go to the word. It can save you. It can transform you. It can give you a new life to you. Receive that. It's the word that will help you to do that. What else? How can I develop that? By pursuing it. 1 Timothy 6:1, 11. Paul is writing to his disciples, said, by you, men of God, flee from all this. And he had a list of things that Timothy had to flee from. And pursue righteousness, godliness, faith, love, endurance, and gentleness. Pursue them. Go after. You need to make a decision. I need to control myself. I need to learn in this kind of situation how to be nice, how to be gentle, how to be humble. I need to know. I need to pursue that. I need to go after that. I don't have. There are some situations in my life that I cannot help myself, and I explode. I say the wrong word, I have the wrong attitude, the gesture, everything, my face kind of, it's everything is wrong. I need to control that. The word, pursue, go after that. The third thing that Paul says, clothing ourselves with it. Clothe yourselves. If you don't have it yet, clothe yourself with that. Colossians 3:12 says, therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Clothe yourself. Put something on top of you. You look bad. Your temper looks terrible. Your attitude, your words, terrible, clothing, put something on top of that. Cover that. Cover that. If you cannot restrain yourself, get out of there. Stop talking. And clothe yourself with a smile there. talk about this later, maybe in the millennium, when Jesus comes back. Not now. Not now. Put the clothing on. Clothe yourself with those. It was very nice talking to you. God bless you. I don't want to talk about that right now. Restrain yourself. Finally. Not finally yet. Another one. Accompany our good deeds. Every good deed means to have gentleness. Look what James 3:13 says. Who is wise and understanding among you? Let him show by his good life, by deeds done in the humility that comes from wisdom. Deeds done in the humility. If you're going to do something good for someone, do it nicely. Yeah, done. Get it. Take it. Yeah, yeah. Don't bother me anymore, okay? No. If you're going to do something good to someone, do it nicely. With gentleness. If you're going to serve someone, serve it right. Even if you don't like the person, you don't want to do it anyway. Every good deed, do it with gentleness. Do it nice. If you're going to serve someone, serve it nice. Do it nice. Put a smile on your face. God bless you. I hope you feel better. I hope this will help you. You need anything else? Can I help with something else? Gentle. Be gentle. Finally, we should develop that by growing to perfection. This is what Paul wrote to Ephesians 4:2. It says, be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Completely. The idea is to mature. We don't have the whole thing right now. Paul says, be completely mature to the point. So you're going to have those things in your life. We don't have. Some of us are struggling how to deal with people. How to treat people. Be gentle. And we should be gentle. You know why? Because all the way back in Matthew 5:5, Jesus said, blessed are the meek, the gentle, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are the gentle. There is a reward for those that are gentle. Jesus is the one that promised the reward. Let us bow our heads and let us pray. Father, help us. We cannot help ourselves. We don't have the power to control ourselves. There are situations, there are circumstances, and there are people around us that push the wrong button all the ways, all the time. Help us to be gentle. Help us to restrain ourselves. Help us to humble ourselves. Help us to be meek. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.